We've been blessed to begin to have Brother Sabino Rodriguez with us, his wife Sylvia, and daughter Elise. They have five children, and very blessed with that. He was called to preach the word since 1975, he has been involved in youth ministry much of his career. He says he's blessed to have been able to serve in the Lord's kingdom there many years. He is a true missionary. He has been in various countries, including Mexico, Guatemala, Honduras, Cuba, Nicaragua, Thailand, Laos, of course, the beloved USA, he says. And he is, again, grateful to have been able to share the word in all those countries. He has been serving at various congregations, including in Manoa, Atlanta, Odessa, Abilene, and Lubbock, Texas, and has been located at Robinson Avenue since April of 2004. Long career there as well, and that attests to his great abilities and talents and sharing the word. We appreciate that very much. So I would like to allow Oliver now to introduce, and we thank you very much.
Nosotros tenemos aquí nuestro hermano Sabino, ya cumplieron sus predicaciones que le hemos pedido, y queremos darle las gracias por su participación con nosotros, y él va en todos los lugares del mundo, y no digamos que todo el mundo no llega, pero nuestros hermanos, ahí está la hermana Silvia, que es su esposa, ahí está Elise, que es su hija, y tiene cinco niños también. Más nietos no sé cuántos. Tiene un montón de
pero cuatro mil nietos.
Ok, pero esperemos que nuestro hermano llegue con bien a su destino. Oremos por él y damos gracias a Dios por esto. Él va en todo lugar a predicar la palabra de Dios. Es el Evangelio. Lleva el Evangelio donde quiera que lo quiera, anda con misionero. Es misionero. Oremos por él. Y ahora le damos el lugar que falta. Que nos predique.
Because in a race, if we all get to the front,
front, or if we all get to the finish line at the same time, we are all first and last. Porque nosotros cuando llegamos, ¿verdad? Cuando corremos una carrera y todos llegamos al mismo tiempo, llegamos al último y llegamos los primeros también. Así es el reino de Dios. Saturday morning we started out with works of the flesh. And I think that we decided as a church and as myself too, that we need to raise the bar a little bit. A lot. El sábado mañana empezamos con las obras de la carne. Y yo y todos nosotros, yo creo, llegamos al punto de que creemos que necesitamos que levantar el nivel un poquito más de mi espiritualidad. Bueno, mucho más de mi espiritualidad. In the afternoon, we talked about the fruit of the Spirit. You know, I can choose my sin. That's what we learned. Aprendimos que yo puedo escoger mi pecado. But I cannot choose the fruit of the Spirit. Pero no puedo escoger el fruto del Espíritu porque tengo que tenerlos todos o no tengo nada. I need to have the fruit of the Spirit, all of them, or else I don't have one. I can't choose to love on Monday, to give on Tuesday, to be patient on Wednesday. No puedo escoger yo el ser paciente el miércoles, el dar dádivas el martes, o amar el lunes. I have to have them all. Tengo que tener las cosas. We finished yesterday with friendship for the world. Terminamos ayer con amistad con el mundo. The world wants us. El mundo nos quiere, a todos nosotros. El mundo nos ama. The world loves each and every one of us, and they want to get their hands on us. Pero si caemos en esa trampa, venimos siendo enemigos de Dios. But if we fall into that trap, we become enemies of God. This morning we spoke about being devoted to doctrine. To the apostles' doctrine. Hoy en la mañana platicamos de estar entregados a la doctrina de los apóstoles. And I want to finish with growing in faith. Y quiero terminar con creciendo en la fe. A longing for the word. Deseando la palabra. Vamos a ver nosotros cinco puntos. I want to look at 5 points and how I can have that longing for the Word of God. 5 puntos en cómo yo puedo tener ese deseo por la palabra de Dios. If you have to eat by 12, we may not be through by 12. Usted tiene que comer a las 12, quizá no vamos a terminar a las 12, vamos a terminar un poquito después. Okay. Even if I go 30 minutes, it's 15 in Spanish, it's 30 in Spanish and 30 in English. No. I hope you enjoy it. First Peter 2. Primera de Pedro, capítulo 2. Versículo 1 al 9. First Peter 2, 1 through 9. Desechando pues toda malicia, todo engaño, hipocresía, envidias y todas las detracciones. Desead como niños recién nacidos la leche espiritual no adulterada, para que por ella crezcáis para salvación, si es que habéis gustado la benignidad del Señor, acercándose a él piedra viva, desechada ciertamente por los hombres, mas para Dios escogida y preciosa. Vosotros también, como piedras vivas, seréis edificados como casa espiritual y sacerdocio santo, para ofrecer sacrificios espirituales aceptables a Dios por medio de Jesucristo. Por lo cual también contiene la Escritura, he aquí, pongo en Sion la piedra principal del ángulo, escogida y preciosa, y el que creyere en él no será avergonzado. Therefore, rid yourselves of all malice, all deceit, hypocrisy, envy, and all slander. like newborn infants, desire the pure milk of the word, so that you may grow up into your salvation if you have tasted that the Lord is good. As you come to him, a living stone, rejected by people, but chosen and honored by God, you yourselves, as living stones, a spiritual house, are being built to be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For it stands in Scripture, "See, I lay a stone in Zion, a chosen and honored cornerstone, and the one who believes in him will never be put to shame." Word of God. This is the day the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad. Este es el día que el Señor nos dio. Seré feliz y me regocijaré en él. Peter is using the Old Testament. A number of the verses that he brings out here are from the Old Testament. Pedro está utilizando el Antiguo Testamento. Varios de los textos que tenemos aquí salen directamente del Antiguo Testamento. Pero hay algo que él quiere enfatizar con esta lección. But there's something that he wants to emphasize with these lessons here. Long for the pure milk of the word. Desear. Aquí en esta porción está sacando muchos textos del Antiguo Testamento, Pedro. Pero él quiere decirnos algo en el versículo 2. Desear por la leche no adulterada. La leche pura. I don't know if you've seen any cats like these, but they're desiring milk. Estos gatitos aquí, ¿verdad? Ellos están deseando la leche pura. La leche que los va a ayudar a crecer a ellos. Milk that will help them grow. They desire any way that they can get their hands on it. They'll get their hands on it. Cualquier manera que ellos puedan obtener esta leche, aunque sea con la cubeta, por la cubeta, ¿verdad? Sí, ellos la van a obtener. ¿Qué de nosotros? Es la palabra de hoy día. Paul expressed that he loved God's word. Pablo expresó muchas veces que él amaba la palabra de Dios. Romans 7:22. Romanos 7:22. Nomás lo voy a repetir así, usted, por favor, lea. Con gozo, dice. Concurro que la ley de Dios está en el hombre interior. I joyfully occur with the law of God in the inner man. Job 23:12. He tesorado sus palabras. La palabra de su boca es más necesario que comida. Job 23:12 says, I have treasured his words. The words of his mouth are more necessary than any food. Amen. Psalm 19 will tell us, my delight is in the law of the Lord. I will meditate on his word day and night. Psalm 19 nos dice a nosotros que meditaré día y noche en su palabra porque es la delicia de mi alma. Psalms 40 and verse 8. I delight to do your will, O God. Your law is within my heart. En Salmos 40 y versículo 8. Mi deleito es hacer tu voluntad, oh Señor. Porque me deleito en tu ley. Romans 1 and Philippians 1. Paul used it to describe a craving of the word so his ministry would be effective. En Romanos 1 y Filipenses 1, Pablo lo usa el deseo de esa palabra para describir para, como comida para él tener un ministerio efectivo. En 2 Corinthians 5, when he says that this tent is going out, and, but he's being renewed day by day. 2 Corinthians 5, he uses it to describe his desire for his longing for heaven. Corintios 5, en el versículo 1 en adelante, ¿verdad? Él está describiendo el deseo por la palabra para llegar al cielo. In 2 Corinthians 9 and Philippians 2, he uses to describe his love journey. En 2 Corintios 9 y Filipenses 2 la usa para describir el amor que él tenía por esa palabra. In 1 Thessalonians 3 and 2 Timothy 2, his deep need, his deep hunger for fellowship was in the Word. 1 Thessalonians 3 y 2 Timoteo 1, acuérdense, ven pronto Timoteo, porque estoy solo. El deseo por la palabra sabía él que le quitaba esa soledad. And so we see that. This pure need for, I'm sorry, this big need for the pureness of the Word. Vemos nosotros la necesidad entonces por la pureza de esa leche espiritual. Aquí Pedro usa una palabra muy interesante. Paul uses a very interesting word here. He does not use logos, which is the word. He uses logikon in the Greek, and this is translated not only as a need, but a desire and a profound love. No usa la palabra logos aquí, usa la palabra logikon, porque en griego, porque esta palabra no solamente dice que es la palabra, pero es la necesidad de la palabra pura en su corazón. It's interesting. Es muy interesante, hermanos, en esta mañana, que Pedro no nos manda leer la palabra. It's interesting that Paul doesn't command us to read. I'm sorry, that Peter doesn't command us to read the word. Paul did that in 1 Timothy 4. Pablo hizo eso en 1 Timoteo 4. Peter does not command us to study the word. Paul did that in 1 Timothy 2. Pedro no nos dice a nosotros que estudiemos la palabra, porque Pablo ya lo había hecho en 1 Timoteo capítulo 2. He doesn't command them to even meditate on the word, as we are commanded in Psalm 19. Pedro no manda a nadie que mediten en la palabra como el salmista lo dice en Salmo 19. He doesn't command them to teach the word. As Paul did in 1 Timothy 4. No nos manda a nosotros a enseñarle a nadie la palabra. Escuche bien. A nadie nos manda Pedro a enseñar la palabra en este verso. He doesn't command us to preach the word. Peter does not command us to preach the word. Paul did that to Timothy in 2 Timothy 4. He doesn't even tell us to search the word. Peter doesn't do that. Pedro no nos dice, no nos sugiere que debemos de escudriñar la palabra. Ya lo había hecho Pablo a Timoteo. ¿Y ahora sí? Entonces, ¿qué hace? He tells us to desire that milk. Desire the pure milk. Nos dice, desea la leche espiritual. This morning, I hope that each one of us would have that same desire. I hope that each one of us would have that same desire, because there are many broken people because they don't listen to God's very simple instruction. Ojalá que todos nosotros deseamos esa leche espiritual, porque hay mucha gente triste porque no escuchan las palabras. have a note or pencil of paper, please take a note. Will be filed in very quick. How can I have that desire? ¿Cómo puedo tener yo ese deseo? How can I, in my busyness, in my world of politics, in a nation that seems to be divided, in abortion issues, in sinful issues, in gay pride parades, or etc. I'm for it, I'm against it, I hate them, I condemn them. In a world like that, en un mundo distorsionado, en un mundo que odia esto y aquello, en un mundo que no quiere esto y no quiere aquello, ¿cómo puedo yo desear la palabra de Dios? It's more important for me to get ready by 7 o'clock in the morning because I need to be working 7:15. That's fine. That's what I'm looking for. Maybe that's what I'm thinking about right now. I'm thinking about traveling from here. 17 and a half hours. Because that's what we are. So much is coming into our head, we don't have time to get that and desire to pure spiritual. Hay tantas cosas que tenemos que hacer que no tenemos tiempo para sentarnos y desear la palabra espiritual. So how am I going to do it? Number one, remember your life source. Número uno, recuerda la fuente de tu vida. Remember the life source. The characteristics are laid out in Romans 3. In a cacophony of quotes coming out of the Old Testament that define our condition without God, without righteousness, without interest, and we are hopeless. En una cacofonía de citas saliendo del Antiguo Testamento, Romanos 3 nos dice a nosotros que estábamos sin Dios, sin justicia, sin interés, estábamos sin esperanza. But why talk about desiring the Word of God? Pero para qué hablar de desear esta palabra de Dios? ¿Para qué? Because you remember that at one time your life was transformed. Porque tú y yo nos acordamos que un día nuestras vidas fueron transformadas. You remember that. You remember that the word is the seed that gave you life. Te acuerdas que la palabra de Dios es la semilla que te dio vida. La semilla te dio vida. James 1:18 says it, and he begot us by the word of truth. Santiago capítulo 1, versículo 18 nos dice a nosotros, hermanos, que Él nos dio, nos nació por medio de su palabra, de verdad. Filipenses 2:16 says, it is the word of life. Filipenses 2:16 nos dice, es la palabra de vida. Hebrews 4:12 says that it's sharper than any two-edged sword. Hebreos capítulo 4, versículo 12 nos dice que esta palabra que nos dio vida es mejor que una espada de dos filos. La palabra está viva y por eso estamos vivos, porque vino de un Dios vivo. The word is alive because it came from a God that is alive. The living word is the very breath of God. La palabra que tú estás leyendo aquí Es la palabra que sale de Dios. Matter of fact, John says it this way. These have been written so that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God. That believing you may have life in his name. Terminando su evangelio, Juan nos dice a nosotros, estas cosas han sido escritas para que creyáis que Jesús es el Cristo, el Hijo de Dios, y creyendo puedas tener vida eterna en su nombre.
Amén.
Yes. So, you remember. Number one, you remember. There's no magic to this. No hay nada mágico de esto. There's nothing magic about remembering. There's nothing. No hay nada mágico en recordar. Se lleva persistencia. It takes persistence, perseverance. Se lleva estudio. It takes study. Se lleva deseando la palabra como nunca. Se lleva que la palabra es la que te da. Te dio vida. You remember that. Number one. You desire that word. You remember your life before. Number uno, te acuerdas de dónde viniste. ¿Quién te dio la vida? La fuente de tu vida. And number two, you eliminate your sin. Y número dos, eliminas. Haces un lado tu pecado. Putting aside again, right? And then he gives you a list. Haciendo un lado y luego nos da una lista. We got that better now. Haciendo todo es un lado. In a congregation where I have preached, I have told everybody that I love the small words. And I believe that small words are the ones that direct our spirituality. Not the big. The big ones I can't understand, okay? I went to Texas Tech, but that doesn't mean anything. I still can't understand. The big ones I can't. I can't understand the little ones. You know? Yo me eduqué, ¿verdad? En universidad, pero no entiendo las palabras grandes. Entiendo las chicas. Y son de tres letras, yo no entiendo. There are three-letter words that I can understand. Four-letter words I can understand. De tres letras yo las entiendo. De cuatro letras yo con muchas ganas las entiendo. But it begins. It says, putting aside malice, all deceit, and all hypocrisy, and all envy, and all slander. In a mini word, A L. Hay una palabra pequeñita, mire, por favor. Sorry about the bus. Pero la palabra nos dice a nosotros, mire, por favor, mire. Dice ahí, dice, desechando pues toda malicia, todo engaño. Me encanta más en el griego porque pone todo en cada una de estas. Todo engaño. Toda hipocresía, toda envidia y toda la destrucción. Can't help horrible in your life. No puede haber una partecita pequeña en tu vida de estas. Now, you take a look at your life and you start shedding things. Te comienzas a mirar tu vida y comienzas a tirar cosas. Cosas que no necesitas. This was a symbol of the fact that salvation marked the shedding of all that was old and the beginning of all that was new. I love it when we get baptized because I don't use these clothes. I use others. And it's a easy one. Cuando nos bautizamos, no nos bautizamos con esta ropa. When we were at camp, like I said, I was a youth minister. enseñaron nosotros, más jóvenes, yo era ministro de jóvenes, y había un canto que usábamos para cada vez que un joven se bautizaba. If you don't mind, if you know it, sing it with me. If you don't know it, you're going to learn it. Pero cante conmigo, por favor, si se acuerdan de ustedes. Oh, the best thing in my life I ever did do. Yes, the best thing in my life I ever did do. Oh, the best thing in my life I ever did do was take off the old robe and put on the new. Oh, the old robe was shattered and battered and torn, but the new robe is spotless and never been worn. Yes, the best thing in my life I ever did do was take off the old robe and put on the new. So all the kids knew that. Every time we had a baptism, they sang that song. Y los jóvenes, cada vez que teníamos un bautismo, cantaban esto. La mejor cosa que yo hice en mi vida, la mejor cosa que yo he hecho en mi vida, es quitarme la ropa vieja y ponerme la nueva. La mejor cosa que yo hice en mi vida. And that's what we need to look at. In the light of a new beginning, in the light of a new love, the ugly and old hindrances hanging on from us, begin to go. Begin to go. No Christian has been one for about 15 years. And he says, you know, I have a lot of problems with anger, man. I get mad quickly. Conozco un hermano que ya tiene como 15 años de cristianismo y él me dice, Sabino, yo me enojo. Yo soy una chispa. Rompo la roja. Y lo malo que podemos decir es que no hay relación entre espíritus. And the only thing I can tell him is that there's no relationship between that and Christianity. We need to grow, we need to grow it all. We need to grow it all. That's how important this is. By desiring the milk, by desiring. Okay, well, let's move on. Number three. Well, still on number two. What we need, repentance. We need genuine repentance. In order for me to be able to take something off and throw it away, I need genuine repentance. Half-made repentance is not going to make it, because I'm just going to throw half the junk away. Necesito arrepentimiento genuino. Porque si no es arrepentimiento genuino y sincero, entonces no me voy a quitarme la mitad de la maldad de mi vida. Necesito más que eso. Number three. Okay. We said. We need genuine repentance. But then we need to admit your need. Admite tu necesidad. We need to admit our need. Admit that you, like newborn babies, need milk. Admit it. Babies, Peter said something very interesting. Tenemos que admitir bien. Pedro dice algo bien interesante. Aquí en esta porción Pedro dice algo bien interesante. Dice, desear, ¿verdad? Como niños recién nacidos. He says something very interesting. He says, desire the spiritual milk like newborn babies. Sometimes I look at it this way, a veces lo miro así y digo, pero es suficiente que digas de mí. No entiendo lo que es de mí. No sabes, no entiendes. Recién nacido, baby. Sometimes I talk to Peter and I tell Peter, I understand what a baby is, okay? He said, no, Peter, you need to understand what a newborn baby is. A newborn baby desires the milk. A newborn baby wants the milk. He doesn't want to call us babies. He wants to call us newborn. No quiere llamarnos a nosotros bebitos, quiere llamarnos bebitos recién nacidos, saliendo del vientre de su madre. Just coming out of the mother's womb. This baby desires immediately milk. Inmediatamente este niño desea, recién nacido, desea leche. Es el único deseo que tiene. This is the only desire, this is the only one that he had. I want milk. Él quiere leche. No conoce otro deseo. He does not know about anything else. He has no other desire. Él no conoce ningún otro deseo, él no quiere otro deseo, él simplemente quiere leche. Él no está impresionado que si su mamá está bonita. He's not impressed in looking whether his mom is pretty or not. Él no está impresionado que si su papá está fuerte y grande. He's not impressed to see if his father is a strong guy, tall guy. He wants milk. Él quiere leche. Es todo lo que él quiere. Él no le importa en qué ciudad nació. He doesn't care what city he was born in. He doesn't care the name of the hospital. Para ese niño no le importa el nombre del hospital. Él lo que quiere es leche. Y va a llorar hasta que tú le des leche. He wants milk. And he's going to cry till you give him that milk. He has a craving for it. Él tiene un deseo profundo por esa leche. Pedro dice, así debemos ser. And Peter says, that's the way that we should be. We should crave. We should need. We should desire. Nosotros debemos de desear esa leche, querer esa leche, anhelar esa leche, y nada más. We have a desperate need. Nosotros tenemos una necesidad desesperada por la palabra. You and I have a desperate need. We cannot go on living without the need, without the spiritual, the need of spiritual help. All of us have a desperate need. All of them. There's a fourth element, I said we were five almost. Pursue and grow. Remember your life source. Recuerda la fuente de tu vida. Eliminate your sin. Elimina tu pecado. Admit your need. Admite tu necesidad. Y cuatro, persigue crecimiento. Pursue growth. Part of the responsibility of the church, parte de la responsabilidad de la iglesia, and part of the responsibility of the preacher, y parte de la responsabilidad del predicador, is to continually make the people see their discontent. Es continuamente hacer que la gente vea que no están contentos. You have to be discontent at wealth. Let me put it this way. You should be discontent with where you are. No puedes estar contento donde tú estás. Alguien ha dicho, ¿verdad? Si alguien está contento donde está espiritualmente, póngase de pie. Someone has asked the question. If you are content where you're at spiritually, stand up. I want to see a perfect person. So that means we all. I'm standing up because I have to. Yo estoy puesto de pie porque tengo que ponerme de pie. But I'm not content where I'm at. Pero yo no estoy contento donde estoy. Yo necesito que me prediquen y me digan. Ponga contento porque me puedo pudrir ahí donde estoy. I need someone to preach to me and teach me not to be content where I'm at, because I can't get rotten where I'm at. I want to grow. Yo quiero crecer. Yo necesito que crecer. I need to grow. I need to pursue that growth. 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 18. 2 Corinthians 3, 18. From one level of glory to the next, to the next, to the next, until we are conformed to the likeness and the image of Jesus Christ. Wow. Es amén. Crecer y crecer es perseguir ese crecimiento hasta que, dice 2 Corintios 3, 18, de un nivel de gloria al otro, hasta que esté conformado a la imagen de Cristo Jesús.
Amen.
Okay? So that I can be like that. But we all know we aren't there yet. Pero todos sabemos que no estamos ahí. And we want to pursue that goal. An increase in spiritual understanding and spiritual growth. Increasing in spiritual understanding and spiritual growth. A deeper delight in biblical things. Un deseo más profundo, hermano. Un deseo más profundo en cosas bíblicas. What if someone came up here, or song leaders came up here, and sang the same words 40 times? ¿Qué si los que dirigen los himnos pasaran al frente y cantaran una estrofa 40 veces? Yo creo que después de 10 veces los trabajaron. I think that after the 10th time they sang it, we tell them to get off. We would tell them to get off. And so that's why I'm saying that we need to be delighted in the things of God and grow in the things of God. Number three, I put a greater love for God. A greater love for God. God is continually greater and greater and greater as I love Him more and more. Dios está haciendo más y más y más grande al yo amarlo más. The fourth one I put here was, it strengthens my faith. Da fuerza a mi fe. Al yo ir creyendo, as I pursue the growth, my faith strengthens. Al yo seguir o perseguir ese crecimiento, mi fe se va haciendo más y más fuerte. Some brethren tell me, I wish I had Abraham's faith. Algunos hermanos me dicen a mí, yo quisiera tener la fe de Abraham. And I would tell them, you don't want Abraham's faith. Yo les digo, tú no quieres la fe de Abraham. But you're going to have to move tomorrow with all your stuff. No, I don't want to move. Yo les digo, tú no quieres la fe de Abraham porque mañana te tienes que mover a un lugar que tú no sabes ni dónde. You're going to have to move your faith. You don't even know where you're going. But you don't want to move your faith. Quieres crecer tu fe. You want to pursue and grow your faith. And your faith. Número cinco. Obedience. Number five, obedience. Number five, obedience. Obedience, 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 obedience. Number five, obedience. Be growing in obedience, constant obedience. When I pursue my growth, I obey more. Al perseguir yo mi crecimiento, voy a obedecer y obedecer. Number five, the last one. We'll get out of here for comfort. Number five and the last one. Número cinco y último. Survey your blessings. Survey your blessings. or counter-blessings. Either way you can look at it. Counter-blessings.
Cuenta tus bendiciones.
I love the song Counter-blessings, you know, both in English and in Spanish. Me encanta la, el himno a mí, este, cuenta tus bendiciones, porque me dice tanto de lo que Dios ha hecho por mí. It tells me God has done so much for me. But he says, come on. Go back to 1 Peter, please. Regresamos primero a Pedro, por favor. Let's look at 1 Peter 2. In verse 3, he says something very interesting. If you have tasted that the Lord is good. En versículo 3 dice algo bien interesante. Si es que habéis ganado y gustado la benignidad del Señor. Who among us? ¿Quién entre nosotros no ha gustado de la benignidad del Señor? Who among us have not tasted the blessings of God? Who? ¿Quién? Es interesante, como lo dice Pedro. It's very interesting, as Peter says. If you have somewhere along the line enjoyed the blessing of God, si tú hay, no sé cuándo, pero ¿qué has recibido las bendiciones de Dios? Yes. If you have received the blessings of God, survey your blessings. En el, este viene a través del Antiguo Testamento, Salmos 34:8. This comes from the Old Testament, Psalm 34:8. Since you tasted the knowledge or the kindness of the Lord is what it says. God has been kind to us. Dios ha sido bondadoso con nosotros. Wouldn't you want to go back to Him and hear from Him? And commune with Him. Si Dios ha sido bueno contigo, ¿no quisieras tú regresar a, con Él, escucharlo a Él, comunicarte con Él? Remember your last words. Recuerda la fuente de tu vida. Eliminate your sin. Elimina tu pecado. Admit your need. Admite tu necesidad. Pursue your growth. Persigue tu crecimiento. Survey your best. Count your best. Cuenta tus bendiciones. And as Peter goes on, al seguir Pedro adelante, él habla in verse 4 and verse 5, he talks about priesthood. Él habla del sacerdocio. He says, we are a royal priesthood. Él dice que nosotros somos un real sacerdote. One would ask Peter, why would you put this in here? Uno le pudiera preguntar a Pedro, ¿por qué pones todo esto aquí? Because the people to whom Peter is talking to know about priests. And priests, they know about them. The temples around them have hundreds of priests. Esta gente conoce por lo que es sacerdotes y mujeres sacerdotes también, porque hay templos ahí alrededor que tienen cientos de sacerdotes. And so Peter is trying to differentiate between them and the church. Pedro está diciendo, esos son sacerdotes, pero ustedes son reales sacerdotes. Peter is saying, you. They are priests, but you are a royal priesthood. That's what he's telling me. And that is a privilege. Y ese es un privilegio hermosísimo que nos está dando Pedro. That is a wonderful privilege that Peter has given to us. We are a royal priesthood. Nosotros somos un real sacerdote. But I began with God. God has been kind to us. For some verses. Since you tasted the kindness of the Lord, communicate. Desde que has saboreado de la bondad de Dios, comunica con él. And this is our last thought this morning. You are a royal priest. Tú eres un real sacerdote. Deseaste la leche. You desired the pure milk. You desired to come back to him by the word. Deseaste la leche pura y quisiste regresar con él por medio de esa leche. Él nos está diciendo a nosotros. He is telling us, just like these priests do sacrifices, we need to sacrifice. We need to sacrifice ourselves. Como le está diciendo Jesús, los sacerdotes hacen sacrificios. Vosotros también haced sacrificios para cada uno. Why has he made us do that? ¿Por qué nos ha hecho él hacer esto? ¿Por qué nos ha hecho un sacerdocio real? Why has he made us a royal priesthood? Why are we a part of a chosen race? Why are we a part of a chosen, of a holy nation? ¿Por qué somos nosotros? ¿Por qué, hermano? Esa es la pregunta, ¿por qué? ¿Por qué somos nosotros una raza escogida, una nación santa, real sacerdotes? ¿Por qué somos así? Because God wants to put us on this place. This is my future child. Look at him. Look at him, look at her. He wants to put us on this place. Él nos quiere poner en la frente de todos. Yo no tengo a nadie aquí. Yo tengo un real sacerdote, nación santa, pueblo adquirido por la sangre de Dios. I don't have a nobody here. I have a royal priest for the holy nation. Look at him. We're on display for God. Jesus would say, you guys are the light of the world. Jesús diría, nosotros somos la luz del mundo. We are. Put on this place. Para que miren mi vida. So people can see my life. 1 Corinthians 11:1. Be in the presence of me, Paul says, as I am of Christ. 1 Corinthians 11:1 dice claramente. Ser ministradores de mí, dice el apóstol Pablo. Como yo soy de Cristo. It's a challenge. It's a big challenge. It's un reto. It's un reto tremendo. But he gives us the Holy Spirit. He gives us his word. And he gave us his Son. Nos da el Espíritu Santo. Nos da su palabra y nos da a Cristo Jesús. You don't need anything else. Ya no necesitas nada más. Tú vas a crecer en la palabra de Dios. You will grow in the word. You will grow. Would you pray with me? Whatever. Almighty Father, we ask you to confirm to our hearts your truth. Padre Celestial, te pedimos que nos ayudes a estar arraigados en tu palabra. We hold in our hand this precious, so often underestimated treasure. Llevamos en nuestras manos un tesoro que muchas veces es menospreciado. And sometimes we underestimate it because of the work that it does kind of stuff. Y a veces, Padre, no le tomamos mucho en cuenta a la palabra, porque su obra es una obra de espacio. But it's ongoing. And the steps from glory to glory may seem like very small, but it's going toward glory. Padre Santo, los pasos que estamos dando de gloria en gloria a veces son bien pequeños, pero la cosa es que vamos caminando a la gloria. You're working them, you are working them through the Holy Spirit. Give us love for your word, an obsession for its truth, and a love for the Father, Son, and Spirit who are with you. Padre Celestial, danos un amor tremendo por tu palabra, una obsesión por su verdad, y reconocer que el Padre, el Hijo y el Espíritu Santo están en este libro tuyo. Se revela todo, so that we can both speak and live and show your excellency. Para que cada uno de nosotros podamos, Santo Padre, hablar de tu palabra, vivir tu palabra y demostrar tus excelencias. We pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. This morning, the invitation is very simple. We have heard it. Hemos escuchado la palabra, pero la invitación es simple. A veces dejamos que la palabra, a veces necesitamos que la palabra germine. But we also understand that we need to let that word grow in each one of us. In each one of us. If you're visiting with us today, we thank you and we honor you. The word has spoken to you. If you've been a Christian for many, many years, the word has spoken to you. Si me está visitando, muchas gracias. Si tienes mucho tiempo en el Evangelio, a ti se te abre la mente. But if you have a desire to become a Christian, pero si tienes un deseo de ser un cristiano, según de Corintios 6, 1 y 2 dice, hoy es el día de salvación. 2 Corinthians, if you have this desire to become a Christian, 2 Corinthians 6, 1 and 2 tells us today is the day of salvation. And we in our language say, if I put off tomorrow, will you do better than that? Y nosotros en nuestro propio idioma decimos, para que estés para mañana, cuando hoy puede ser salvo. Te invitamos en el nombre de Jesús. We invite you in the name of Jesus. We invite you through Jesus. Te invitamos por medio de la palabra de Dios. Ven aquí. Come to me. Let us stand and we'll sing a song of invitation. Anywhere we can help. Anything we can do. Great. Okay.